Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Vikram. In this class, we will try to understand number of levels and number of multiplexers required. So this design, the design of this multiplexer, it is a 16 by 1 multiplexer by using 2 by 1 multiplexer. This discussion has already been made in our previous class. If you haven't watched that video, please watch that video. If you are asked to design a P by 1 multiplexer by using a Q by 1 multiplexer, so how to design and all those aspects has been already discussed in our previous video. It is P by 1 multiplexer by using a Q by 1 multiplexer. If you are asked to design these kind of multiplexers, so here the question is, the frequently asked questions are, how many multiplexers are used in order to design a P by 1 multiplexer by using a Q by 1 multiplexer? Here the value of P is 16 and the value of Q is 2, which means that a 16 by multiplexer designed by using 2 by 1 multiplexer. Okay. So if such questions are asked and they are asked you to find the number of multiplexers used and the number of levels used. So these are very frequently asked questions. So do we need to draw this diagram and we have to count all those multiplexers? No, it is not required. So we will try to understand the mathematical logic behind this diagram. So where we can identify the number of levels required and also the number of multiplexers required to construct a P by 1 multiplexer by using a Q by 1 multiplexer. So what is the mathematical logic? So from this diagram, can you count the number of multiplexers required? It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. 15 multiplexers are required. And how many levels are there? 4 levels are there. So in order to identify this, in order to get this, what is the mathematics behind this is, for example, if you are given with a P multiplexer, if you are asked to construct a P multiplexer by using P by 1 multiplexer by using a Q by 1 multiplexer, so what we have to do is we have to divide this. Okay, so now P is here, it is 16. 16 by 2, what is the value that we are going to obtain? It is 8. And again divide this 8 by 2. So again divide this 8 by 2. Okay. So if you divide 8 by 2, we are going to get 4. Again divide this 4 by 2. So how many times we have to divide it? So how many times we have to divide it is until the value is equal to 1, is less than or equal to 1. So until you get the value of this division is less than or equal to 1, we have to divide that. With that, we are going to get the number of levels. Okay. So what does that mean is here 4 by 2 is 2 and again 2 by 2 is equal to 1. So here we can stop the number of multiplexers required. So as and when we stop this here, it means that just one multiplexer, so we need only one multiplexer. So now the sum of all these values is going to give the number of multiplexer. What is this sum of all these numbers? It is 15. How many levels are there? See here, 4 levels are there. Okay, so what we are trying to do is, so this value can be obtained by P by Q power 1 and this value 4 can be obtained by P by Q power 2, P by Q power 2 and this value can be obtained by P by Q power 3 and this value can be obtained by P by Q power 4. So what it is, P by Q power 1 is 16 by 2 power 1, which is 2, and for this it is 16 by Q square, which is Q value is 2, 2 square is 4. Okay, 16 by 4 is 4. And if you take this value, it is 16 by 2 power 3. 2 power 3 is 8. 16 by 8 is 2. And this value is P by Q power, 2 power 4, which is 16. So the value of P is 16. 16 by 16 is 1. So here, the value, the number of levels required is this 4. So Q power 4. So until you get the value less than or equal to 1, we have to divide that. So how can we represent this as? How can we represent this as? It is, so we have to divide this number until we get p power q power k is less than or equal to 1. So this, in order to get the number of levels, p by q power k should be divided until you get the value less than or equal to 1. Okay, so in order to get the value of k, what we have to do is, it is q power k. So if you swap this, in the sense, if you read it in this way, it is q power k is greater than or equal to p. If you do this, if you find the value of k, k is equal to log of p base q. See here. So to get the value of k is equal to log of p base q, and this should be there in seal value. This should be a seal value. Why we have taken this seal value, that we will try to understand in our later examples. Just for this video, just try to remember that log of p base q should be in the seal value. The upper value has to be taken. Okay, so now k value is equal to, k value means we are going to get the number of levels. Okay, so the number of levels to construct a 16 by 1 multiplexer by using a 2 by 1 multiplexer is, it is log of 16 base 2, which can be written as 4 log 2 base 2, which is 1. So the value is 4. Okay, for example, if you are asked to construct 1024 multiplexer by using 4 by 1 multiplexer, how to do it? So do we need to construct this diagram and we have to count all those numbers and all those multiplexer and say the answer? No, it is not required. So to get the number of levels, it is log of 1024 base 4, which is log of 2 power 10 by 2, which is 5. The number of levels are 5 levels. Okay, so the number of levels are 5 levels are required to construct this one. To get the number of multiplexes required, what we have to do is, it is sigma of k is equal to 1 to log p base q. Okay, so 4 times we have to repeat, and it is, the sum has to be done on p by q power k. Okay, so this is what we have to do. So just find the sum of all these. If you are asked to find the number of multiplexers used to construct a 16 by 1 multiplexer by using a 2 by 1 multiplexer, how to do that is, it is we will take the values directly. It is 16 by 2. Okay, it is 16 by 2 plus 16 by 2 square plus 16 by 2 cube plus 16 by 2 power 4. So here p by q means we have got it is 4. We have to take from 1 to 4. Now if you sum up all these values, it is 16 by 2 is 8 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1, which is equal to 15. So the total number of multiplexers required to implement a 16 by 1 multiplexer by using a 2 by 1 multiplexer is 15. Similarly, you take any example of any size, we can directly get the solution. So these two formula, these two mathematical background that is required to identify the number of levels and the number of multiplexers required to construct a p by 1 multiplexer to a q by using a 2 q by 1 multiplexers. So these are the formulas that are required to be understood. Don't try to remember, try to understand this. So this is the mathematical background behind this. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. And if you have any doubts regarding these concepts, please post your doubts in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.